Did you know that the second largest expenditure of the average American family goes into transportation? This percentage equates to an average of over $800 every month. As large as this figure might sound, it only applies to the average families. Have you ever wondered how much the richest CEOs in the world spend on getting to their numerous meetings all around the globe? Well, you're about to find out some of the richest people in the world like to, you know, fly and move around. Hey guys, welcome back to another video on the channel. Starting from number 10 down to 1, we are counting down some of the richest CEOs and business owners that like to meet up with their unending board and shareholder meetings. Number 10, Donald Trump. Billionaire, playboy, philanthropist, ex-president, Donald Trump is credited as the richest person and the only billionaire to have lived in the White House. Trump does not make his net worth open to public, but based on his various known sources of income, some organizations have been able to come up with an estimate, and it adds up to approximately $2.4 billion. According to Forbes, a large part of the ex-president's fortune lies in the New York City real estate. Furthermore, Trump owns a golf course, a winery, has licensed his name to numerous companies globally. So, apart from when he had to ride in the designated beast in Air Force One for the US president, what does Donald Trump like to transport in? In 2011, Donald Trump secured a secondhand aircraft that was nicknamed Trump Force One. He purchased it from the late Microsoft founder Paul Allen. Trump spent extravagantly in pimping this plane to premium billionaire status. The plane is fitted with aesthetically pleasing cream leather seating, a cinema, a master bedroom with a double bed, and a spacious bathroom featuring a shower and a 24-karat gold sink. But that's just in the air. When Trump is on the ground, he enjoys a ride in his luxurious Rolls-Royce Phantom, which is the most expensive automobile in his garage. Number 9, we have Roman Abramovich. If you watch the English Premier League, then you probably know this name as the owner of the Chelsea Football Club. He is a smart businessman that has crashed on different sales and investments over time. However, he also is a big giver. Roman Abramovich has given so much that he has donated more money than any Russian alive. His donations between 1999 and 2013 add up to an estimated of $2.5 billion. His current net worth, according to Forbes, is set at about $15 billion. That's a lot of money. But this does not mean that this billionaire does not also enjoy splurging on his own personal needs. Roman Abramovich is said to have a fleet of planes that adds up to over $65 million. The crown jewel of his fleet is the Boeing 767-33A-AER. That's a name. This plane contains a buffet hall that seats 30 people and a bedroom with a double bed. This flying fortress also has an advanced missile warning system and radar jamming tech. This man's ready for war! At number 8 we have Alisher Usmanov. Alisher Usmanov is probably the least popular person on our list. However, that is just if you do not live in Russia. He's a billionaire that has amassed most of his wealth from metal and mining operations. He also has made some pretty impressive investments that have supported the number of zeros that are attached to his net worth. Another thing Alisher Usmanov owns is the biggest and most expensive private planes in the world. He reportedly spent a minimum of $238 million for purchasing the plane alone. As you would expect, even more millions were spent to raise the plane to billionaire taste. This estimates the plane to cost about $500 million or more. Just think about that. Number 7, Mukesh Ambani. With a net worth of $76.2 billion, Mukesh Ambani is the richest man in all of Asia. He is also the largest shareholder of Reliance Industries Ltd, which is the most valuable company in India by market value. Also, Mukesh Ambani lives in the second most expensive property in the world, just coming behind Buckingham Palace. This luxurious estate is said to have cost the billionaire about $1 billion. For a person who spent so much to ensure that the living conditions were nothing short of premium, you can already expect that his transportation must match up to it. First off, Ambani has previously gifted his wife a completely revamped private jet that was fitted with a bar, a master bedroom, and more. As for a little something for himself, Mukesh Ambani bought a Boeing business jet too. This business jet has everything you could want, from a mind-blowing business suite to a full-sized bathtub. The designer of the plane reported that his client wanted to have all the comforts of home, even in the sky. At number 6, we have Larry Page. This American computer scientist and internet entrepreneur, popularly known as one of the masterminds that came up with the lifesaver that is Google, while he has stepped down as chief executive officer from Google, the man was able to gather a lot of wealth from his time at Google alone, and currently has a net worth of about $102.7 billion. I don't even have $102. So, what tickles Paige's fancy when the time comes to move from point A to point B? Well, in 2005, he and his fellow Google founder, Sergey Brin, spent good money on a Boeing 767-200. Over time, they have continuously added different powerful crafts to their fleet. It's important to note that they also have a private terminal at the San Jose Airport in California. Number 5. Warren Buffett. Next on the list is the father of investment, the Oracle of Omaha, and a man with the most financial experience you can find anywhere. Unlike most of the people we have discussed so far, Warren Buffett is a rather frugal fellow with a very conservative spending culture. While he started as a newspaper boy going around with a bicycle, Warren Buffett has made a lot of long-term investments that have paid off and earned him a net worth of about $103.7 billion. Before recently, Warren Buffett has also been an open critic of people who use private jets. Nonetheless, Warren Buffett has now been converted and also transports himself in a private jet. Buffett bought a Bombardier Challenger and renamed it the Indefensible. With this name, he tried to acknowledge his stance as an anti-private jet guy. However, with time, Buffett began to see why this transport method was so popular amongst people who could afford it. After coming to this understanding, he then changed its name again to Indispensable. This Challenger is large enough to carry from 9 to 19 passengers in a luxurious and spacious cabin. Another interesting fact about this plane is that it has very low noise and vibration. Considering that the 90-year-old investor spends most of his time in the air, this feature is one to die for. Number 4. Bill Gates. Here's another billionaire that needs no introduction whatsoever. Popular for his time as the co-founder of Microsoft Corporation and being one of the revolutionaries in technology in the 70s and 80s, Bill Gates currently has a net worth of $129.9 billion US dollars. Furthermore, he and his wife run the largest private charitable foundation in the world. This foundation is targeted at changing the face of global health and creating equal opportunities for people all over the world. Just like Warren Buffett, however, Bill Gates is a thrifty guy. But he did manage to get himself to splurge on his Bombardier BD-700 Global Express private jet. He bought this jet in 1997 and calls it his guilty pleasure. Number 3. Elon Musk. Often referred to as real-life Iron Man, this genius billionaire has a net worth of $173.6 billion. At the beginning of 2021, Elon Musk momentarily stole the title of richest man in the world from Jeff Bezos. The notable companies with Musk's name on it include Tesla, SpaceX, Neuralink, and The Boring Company, which actually isn't that boring. His concentration on the SpaceX Starship project made Musk move to Texas. However, the headquarters for SpaceX and Tesla are both in California. This simply implies that the man does a lot of travel back and forth to keep everything in check. Elon Musk has two private jets for his constant commutes, the Gulfstream G550 and the Gulfstream G650ER. These planes have been customized to just how Elon likes it, with handcrafted chairs, Wi-Fi, and 4 different relaxation and dining sections. Number 2. Bernard Arnault. Bernard Arnault is a French businessman and art collector. He oversees a business empire that covers 70 brands, including Louis Vuitton and Sephora. In 2018, Arnold became the richest person in fashion, zooming past Amancio Ortega of Zara. He also has held the title of the richest person in the world, however short-lived, between December 2019 and January 2020. However, he is the richest person in France and the richest person in Europe. Apart from the luxury trains that Bernard has in his vault, this man blew a whopping $54 million on a Dassault Falcon 7X business jet. This French billionaire is seen on maintaining a fancy lifestyle. How? Well, he also has a massive 333-meter yacht called Symphony. This yacht comes with a 6-foot swimming pool, a jacuzzi, and cinema, all of these going for a total of $150 million. And finally, at number 1, Jeff Bezos. Would a list of rich CEOs be complete without the man, the myth, the legend himself, Jeff Bezos? After announcing that he will be stepping down as the CEO of Amazon in the second half of 2021, the man currently has a net worth of over $200 billion. Bezos embraces luxury without any form of shyness about the matter. Bezos owns 2 Gulfstream G650ER private jets. This is an aircraft that has smashed several speed records and has received an aviation award for the class it offers. When Bezos is grounded, he is seen in his Ferrari, Pininfarina, Sergio, or his Bugatti Veyron, Mansory, amongst others, all running into millions of dollars in cost price. And that brings us to the end of this video. Let us know in the comment section down below which of these was your favorite and why. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications for more videos, and we'll see you in the next one.